Hello, this is Alex from Cables.gl. Let's take a look at how we can import a 3D scene into Cables and reference the camera views that we've set up in our 3D package. And in my case, that is Blender. I'll show you this scene that I've pre-prepared and we'll most likely rebuild it from scratch because it's got a number of things that I want to show and show you how to build. We'll also take a look at Blender because there are some essential things you need to remember when exporting your scene for Cables to be able to reference the information of the camera. And yeah, that's pretty much it. All right. So what I have here is the 3D scene that is a GLTF file with some cameras already embedded. And I have a little camera switcher here that allows us to animate between the two cameras, which is really interesting. And of course, there's some materials and a skybox for fun. All right, so let's look at the scene first. If you notice, there is a dropdown here now that allows us to switch between the embedded cameras. And if I select the second camera, our view switches to the camera that I've set up in Blender. So if we'll Alt-Tab to Blender and I'll pop open this view here and click this camera button, we will be looking at the first view. And if I select my second camera, we'll see the view that is also in Cables right now. So this is our second camera and this is our first camera. And then in Blender, this is our second camera and this is our first camera. All right, so that's pretty cool, but let me show you the animation between the two cameras that is pretty neat. So if we select none here, the GLTF Camera View Matrix op will then take over the controls of our camera view. And with this little setup here, I can switch between the two cameras with a mouse click. So look at this. Bam. Bam. Amazing. So I think it's very useful, or actually like a quick way to animate cameras or maybe set up in a more familiar way inside your 3D package and then easily animate those camera views inside Cables without having to use an animation track or maybe some sort of animation ops. All right, so let's delete everything so it doesn't scare us too much. All right, so we have a main loop. All right, and now let's go to Blender. I'll move my camera a bit so we're in regular Blender view. And I've imported this 3D model that I've downloaded from Sketchfab that I will link below. And I've set up two cameras here, but let's even set up completely new cameras too. All right, so now we have a 3D scene without any cameras. Let's create a new camera. Add. You know, I'm not really an expert in Blender, but hopefully this isn't too slow for you. All right, so add camera. And this is our camera. And what I like to do is to use my viewport to adjust where the view is so I don't have to use the transforms to place the camera somewhere. All right, so if we click this button, wow, all right, we're now viewing the scene through the camera. And if we lock the camera view to the viewport, whenever we manipulate the view, we're also moving the camera. Okay, so let's zoom in here and maybe pan a little bit. And let's just say this is our first camera. Great. Let's add another camera. Add camera. And this is our camera too. I do want to rename this. I don't have to, but I just don't really like this .001 for my second camera name. I'll rename it to camera two. And also take control over it by default, this is deselected, but what you will need to do is select this local camera tick box here and then switch to camera 2 and then adjust where it is. Let's put it right in front of the truck. All right, so these are our two cameras and we're done basically. Now, the most important thing is how do we export this stuff? Click on File, move the mouse down to Export and GLTF 2.0. Now, what we need to make sure is ticked is inside this Include tab. And you'll notice that I have Limit to Selected Objects. And that means only the selected objects from Blender will be exported. So I've just selected my camera and the model. And the most important thing is that we will need to export camera data. So you need to make sure this is checkmarked. Okay, so we'll name this Truck 2 and export. And then let's go and upload it to Cables. Like so. All right, so now we will have our new scene with the new cameras that we've created. Let's connect it to the main loop and give it a basic material. I'll give it a texture that I've already uploaded and connected like so. All right, so here's our scene. Now, how do we look at the cameras that we've exported? Let's look at GLTF Scene. And since version 3, we have a camera dropdown here. And before we click that, let's look at the Show Structure button. And if we click it, and we'll see that we have our model and also our cameras with the hierarchy showing there's a camera underscore orientation. And those nodes are the ones that contain the camera matrix information that we'll use as we go further. All right, so let's close this and let's try out this new dropdown. Okay, that's supposed to be our first camera. And this is our camera 2. Now let's check it against Blender. And I'll use this camera button. And this is our camera 2, and this is our camera 1. And then if we'll go back to Cables, this is our camera 2, and this is our camera 1. And now let's look at Blender again. And you'll see something is off, right? It's it looks actually very different. And let's debug this. All right, so we have a rescale button here. We probably don't really need to use it. Okay, but that doesn't actually change anything. All right, so let's go back to Blender. And if you look at the camera, you'll see that it has a focal length. And then if we look at this tab here, there's also some settings for the sensor. Okay, but I don't think Cables is getting this information. So how do we fix this? Well, we can drop in a Cables camera. And then adjust the IZ, which is the distance from the object. We will be at 0. And then here's our field of view. And actually, we can match it exactly how it is in Blender. All right, so I'll use these twigs here to kind of eyeball it. All right, maybe a bit closer, like so. Yeah, and now it's looking pretty much exact. Nice. Cool. All right, so now you know how to adjust the field of view difference between your 3D package and camera in Cables. Okay, so this is our basic setup now. We can switch the camera with a dropdown. But what else can we do? There was a new op released in the August update called GLTF View Camera View Matrix. Okay, let's use this one. All right, so let's look at it. It has a node name input, and then it has a matrix output. Okay. And what do we, how do we hook it up, and what do we put into this node name? Okay. So let's look at our GLTF scene. And since we're going to be using a special op to reference the cameras, we actually should select no camera on the GLTF scene op itself. All right, so everything is different now. And let's connect this to the GLTF scene, because this operator needs to be connected to GLTF scene, since it will be referencing a camera from the scene you connect it to. So we'll connect it to the next trigger out. And then let's look at the structure, and then we'll see these camera nodes with the information we need, and they're called camera underscore orientation. So let's copy paste this by selecting the text and pasting it in here. And you see the matrix is now being output and the node has been found. And if I delete this, the node is not found and the matrix is the last one that I could find. So we'll leave it to, we'll leave it as camera orientation. And now how do we use it? Well, we need to use multiply view matrix. And this will take a incoming matrix and then apply it to the scene we have. So let's put it above the camera and then connect it to the op. Nice. Okay, so we'll adjust the field of view again to correctly match Blender. Let's double check it again. Okay. All right, so we have our camera orientation being referenced from the GLTF scene and applied to the multiply view matrix. And to copy the switcher I had in the beginning of this video, let's put in a string switcher. Switch string op, and we'll paste our camera orientation name here. And then the second one was camera two underscore orientation. So we'll apply it to the string one index, camera two. Okay, so now the GLTF camera view matrix is getting the name of the node from the switch string operator. And if we change the index to one, our camera changes. That's pretty cool. All right, so I want to do this with a mouse click, actually. That's really what I want to do. And to do this is pretty simple. We use a trigger counter loop. Connect it to the switch string. We need to limit the trigger counter loop to two numbers, 0 and 1, because that's the only ones we will be using in the switch string. So string 0 and string 1, we'll get the number 0 and 1. And then we'll use a mouse button to increment this counter loop. And then once we reach the maximum of 1, it will start over at 0 again. So if we click the canvas, we switch between the two cameras. Nice. Okay, so what I'm working up towards here is the coolest thing, which is Animatrix. That was a really good movie, by the way. All right, so what we need to do here is to make sure that the Animatrix is getting a constant trigger before our scene. And to do this, we'll place a sequence op and then move over our scene to from the first node to somewhere here, maybe. It doesn't really matter. Just as long as it's after the Animatrix. And then we'll plug the Animatrix in. And then instead of feeding mul view matrix with the GLTF Camera View Matrix, we will put it into the AnimMatrix and then to the Multiply View. So, did you see that? It is now animated. And what happens when we click the button? It animates between the two cameras. All right, so pretty interesting, a little bit involved. I hope you stuck around and have some ideas of how you can use this in the future. And yeah, look forward to more of these videos soon. Bye.